Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I want to show you how to get more than just 8 groups out of your Waves eMotion LV1 Classic. Now, this console has those 8 groups, but you can get up to 32 groups, either mono or stereo, on your LV1. And in this video, I want to show you how. But if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with your production gear no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and figure out how I got 32 groups on this console, or up to 32 groups on this console. So with the Waves eMotion LV1 Classic, if you go into setup, we can have our different mixer configurations up here on the left-hand side. So we have 16 input channels, we have 32 input channels, or 64 input channels. Now, the main difference between a 16 input show and a 32 or 64 is going to be the amount of processing we have on the groups side of things. So we can see that on our 16 input channel, we have our 8 mono or stereo aux mixes. And then we have some matrices in our mix buses, of course. But on the 32 input, we have 8 stereo groups, 8 mono or stereo effects auxes, and then 16 mono or stereo monitor mixes. Now, what in the world am I talking about with 32 groups then? If it only says 8 groups here, well, it doesn't actually matter what it's called. You can still use them as a group. So the mono or stereo effects auxes or the monitor mixes, if you don't need to have them set up as a effects send or a monitor mix, and I'm talking about you guys who are mixing front of house and have a separate monitor console, you don't need to have those monitors inside your console. So you can just reuse them, title them something different, and use them as a subgroup. So let me show you how I have this broadcast console set up for a show that I have coming up later this year. And if I go to my Mixer 1, we can see all of my channels here. So I have 12 vocals on this. I have my kick in, kick out, snare top, snare bottom. We can go to my next thing here. We have my toms, overheads, hi-hats. We have bass, guitars, keys, tracks, and then we have more tracks, choir, D-pad, some aux perk, and some available channels as well, and then some available channels for me when last minute things get added. And then we have a Spanish interpreter, there's some audience mics. We have a general session portion of this, which includes speech and videos, which I'm just taking a subgroup mix off of the front of house console for this broadcast. And then we actually have some dedicated content that is specific for this broadcast show, where we have 5 mics, and those are set up as a little panel, side, stage, if you will. And so I have all of these 64 channels being used, except for these, you know, channels that are right here that I'm not really using. But I have all these 64 channels being used with something. Now, this is a big, complex show file. And what's great is I have all of these plugins, all of these things, including mastering plugins and everything on my broadcast side, and I'm only running 84% on my internal server of the Waves eMotion LV1 Classic. So, I mean, the server on this thing is great. But so let's actually talk about these groups. I'm just on a soapbox here. So we have these groups right here. So this is where our groups show up. These are our 8 groups. And so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And obviously I've named them something different. Now on the channel side, if we go look at our channels, and we go and pull open, say, my kick drum. So here's my kick drum. Now I can access my groups by just clicking right here. So if I wanted to add one of my channels to a group and have that group process the audio and then have it sent to the left right, instead of having this channel go to the left right like this, what I would do is I would send it to a group first, unassign it from the left right bus, and then I would need to go to that group. So for instance, we can go down to my groups here and we can pull up my kick group. And then we can have this group go to the left-right bus. But actually, I'm doing some more complex stuff with this specific show file. So I'm actually sending all of my channels. So I have my kick in, my snare top, snare bottom, my kick out, of course, my toms, my overheads. All of those things are being sent to these four groups. So here's my kick, here's my snare, here's my toms, here's my cymbals. Now my channels are being sent to these four groups. And then these four groups are being sent to my drum bus and a parallel drum bus. Now, I have some other videos on parallel drum buses, but it's a way of getting a lot more sound out of the drums without having an excessive amount of volume. So it can just create a really good bass sound of the drum set. So because I have a little bit more complex stuff, I have my channels, so my kick out. If I go look at my channel, it's going to group one. And then if I go and select my group one, here is my kick channel, it is being sent to group five and six because the Waves LV1 Classic can do group to group sending with the processing. So I have my kick going to my drum and my drum parallel, which my drum parallel is on group six. And then here on my snare, it's the same thing. And then my toms, same thing. And then the overheads is not going in my parallel drum bus. It's only going to my drum bus. So I have all of my drums, and those are being sent to my drums and my drum parallel. And those are going to the left-right bus. Now, I have similar things going on with the vocals. So all of my vocal channels, if we go and select them, all of my vocal channels are going to my group 7 and my group 8, which is my vocal group and my vocal parallel group. Similar thing to the drum parallel, just getting more body and more volume out of the vocals without being an excessive amount of volume getting into clipping range. Now, this would be the extent of my 8 groups if I wanted to just contain myself into the thought that group is supposed to stay as a group and that the auxes are supposed to be an aux and monitors and everything like that. But what's great is if we go and dig in on our sends here, our effects sends have the ability of going to the left-right bus. And this is the way for all 8 of our effects sends. In fact, here's my guitar parallel bus. And this is kind of fun. When you have a guitar solo, you can have your lead guitar go to a guitar parallel bus and have that going to the left, right. And then you can just raise this up when that guitar solo is happening, and you can just create this really good boost of sound. Now, if we go down into my monitor section here, and let me pull up my mixer one here, we can see that I have my bass group, my electric guitar, acoustic guitar, keys, tracks, percussion, aux, and then my effects. All of my effects coming from here, from this layer, so my vocal delay, long delay, verb, snare verb, drum verb, instrument verb, all of those can go into this effects right here. Now, if we click into this and go look at our channel, we can see that all of them are going to the left-right bus. And this is great. So all of my channels are going into all of these subgroups and then being sent to my left-right bus where I have a little bit of minimal processing. Now, the main thought behind doing a subgroup is to process that group of instruments globally. So, for instance, my kick drum, I can go and add, say, torque. So let's go and pull up my kick drum group here. And so I have my kick drum group with torque live, adding a little bit of low end below the fundamental frequency. So this is going to be helpful for if we have a kick drum that's a little bit thin and I want a deeper sounding kick drum, we can add this plugin to our kick group rather than adding it to both the kick in and the kick out. We can just do it simply one time in this group. And we're taking the pair of the kick in and the kick out. Those are being sent to the kick group, being processed globally with these select plugins that I have here. And then that's being sent to the drum group, which is having the kick, snare, toms, all the cymbals, and then that drum group then has global EQ or global compression or whatever we want to have done on that group of channels. Similarly, if we did this on the electric guitar, if we had multiple electric guitars, our guitar group would be processing those channels as one. And this is really helpful if you want to just do some global changes real quick on the fly in the middle of a show. Say you need to get brighter vocals all around. Well, all you have to do is go to your vocal group and add some EQ and boost a little bit of high end on that. Now, on the channels side, sending to these monitor sends that I have here. So let's go pull up mixer one here. So I have these eight channels here, all being as groups. Now, notice that I have the option of doing a mono or a stereo. And if I go and click into this group, I can change between mono or stereo just like this. So here's my stereo and here's my mono. And I can, of course, change this on the fly if I need to. I'm not going to pan a bass guitar. I'm going to leave it straight in the middle because I want that sound going everywhere. Now, my electric guitars, those are definitely going to be in stereo because I'll pan my electric guitars. If I have two guitarists, I'm going to pan them slightly where they are on stage. And so this is an example of a group that I want to leave in stereo. Acoustic guitar, maybe there's multiple guitars for acoustics that's up on stage, similar thing. Keys, this is definitely something I want to leave stereo because typically we have a stereo keys and maybe we have multiple keys and they are all in stereo. Tracks would be another one. So all of these can be mono or stereo, but from the channels, if I'm wanting to send them to one of these groups, so let's go pull up my bass guitar. So here's my bass amp. Now, I have the ability of pulling up my effects sends up here, and then my 16 channels of monitors. Now, I've already renamed these groups, and we can see that I am sending my bass guitar at zero post-pan to this monitor send, which is now titled the bass group. And that bass group is being sent to my left-right bus. Now I have the ability of changing the tap point going to these auxes or monitors or effects and everything like that. So if we just click here, here's an input tap. So this is straight off the preamp. Pre-fader is obviously before my channel fader. And then we have post, which is going to be after my channel fader. And then we have post pan, meaning that if I pan an instrument, it's going to pan it being sent to that group. Perfect example is going to be my keys. So I have my keys one, and this is panned slightly to the left. And then I have my keys two, and this is panned slightly to the right. And this panning is going to send to my keys group because this is set up on post pan. Now, again, remember, if we're sending through a subgroup, you need to make sure that it's not being sent to the left-right bus as well, because we want to be processing this channel in our subgroup. So make sure that if you're using a subgroup, you have it set to not left-right, because we want to have the left-right send being off of that subgroup. So we can see that I have my toms. Those are going to my groups here, and then we have bass amp on my monitors. There's my bass send for my bass amp and my bass DI. We have my electric guitar that's post-panned to my electric guitar here. We then have my keys that's going down here. We have tracks, which is being sent post-pan to the tracks. Ah, here we go. My tracks too, because I haven't used it yet, is not set up to go to my tracks group. So to simply change this, we can just go ahead and click into all of these to be post-pan. And then one really cool trick is if you have a keyboard, and I have my little mini keyboard here, if you press and hold Alt and then tap on the fader, it'll automatically turn on and jump to 0 dB, which is awesome. So you can actually do this on any fader on the console. If you have a keyboard and you press Alt, you can just tap it and it will go all the way up to zero for any single fader, which is fantastic. And so now we have my tracks channel going through to my tracks group here. And we can just verify and see, we don't have this set up correctly on these either. So we can just go ahead and change these. Now, of course, I don't have to change all of them, but here we go, press Alt and boom. And then tracks four. Now, say this was sent to the left, right. Of course, I would want to unassign it from the left, right, and then assign it to my groups here. And here we go. And press Alt and send it to my tracks. So we have these tracks, and these are all being sent again to my groups. So here is my total group setup. So I have a kick. Let's go to mixer one so you can see this a little bit better. I have a kick, I have a snare, toms, cymbals. Those are all groups, and those are being sent to my drums and my drum parallel minus the cymbals. We then have vocal and vocal parallel. We then have some effects, And then if we go down to my monitors, I have my bass group, my my electric guitar group, acoustic guitar group, keys, tracks, percussion. Aux is just another group that I have available just in case there's last minute adds. So for instance, if there was a violin or a cello or something like that, I can go ahead and add that in the fly, and I already have processing available to it that I haven't used. So that's why I call it aux. And then I have my effects. So let's go ahead and listen to this. So again, I have my channels all here. I have the ability of turning things up and down as I need to. And then all of these are going into my groups. So here's my kick, snare, toms, cymbals. Here's my drum group. Here's my drum parallel group. And then down here we have my bass, my electric guitar, all of that. And so what I was saying about this parallel guitar group, when we have a fun little solo, it is turning it up, but it's giving it a compressed sound. So this is very compressed. And so it's able to raise up the whole body of that electric guitar. Now, this is going to be super helpful for you guys that are using this as a broadcast or a front of house mixer that doesn't have the need for sending monitors off of this desk. Now, of course, I can still utilize some of those monitor mixes for monitor mixes if I need to. So for instance, if I go and check this out, I have my monitor 13 and 14 unused, and I can still set this up as a monitor mix. So say I have a lead vocalist who definitely wants the front house mixer as the monitor send for that mix. And maybe the rest of the band is just utilizing the monitor mixer that's on location at that venue or gig. Maybe I can use my monitor 13 as my lead vocal. So I could go ahead and type in here, and this is going to be lead vox. And we can set this up as a monitor mix specifically for our lead vocalist, for instance. Now, the thing that I love about the Waves eMotion LV1 Classic is that it is configurable in so many different ways. Not only can we have our dedicated 8 groups, but then we have our 8 effects sends and our 16 monitor buses. And all of those can be set up to really anything that we want it to, which is the beauty of the LV1 system. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the LV1 system, or really any of the other production equipment that's out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. Now, if you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.